at 10 a.m. on May 17th last year, the Juman District Woman MP Jessica Ababiku was sworn in to become the first member of the 11th Parliament. Today marks a full year since the 11th Parliament was inaugurated with 529 legislators.
That I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
A journey that started amid COVID-19 restrictions has been rough and tough as Parliament suffered 40% budget suppression that has suffocated a number of activities, especially in the mandate of oversight, as committee could not make field visits to monitor progress of many government projects.
Most of the work, actually people don't get chance to watch it, and that's work in committees and work in the field. So we came into this term with the budget of Parliament suppressed to almost 50%.
The death of the former Speaker Jacob Olanya was a big blow to the 11th Parliament as it paralyzed the steady progress of the House that was taking off from the orientation stage. Business went to a standstill for almost a month as the country mourned the shocking demise.
Speaker, Honorable Jacob, actually it ushered in a vacuum. Why am I saying that? I'm not saying that the people who are presiding over, they are incompetent. They are very competent. But there is time for everything. There is always a scenario whereby after Honorable Kadaga, Olanya sits in. After Olanya, then Honorable Among sits in. But here comes someone who was not yet prepared enough.
Out of the 12 months of the 11th Parliament, two legislators, Muhammad Segirinyi of Kawempe North and Alan Sewanyan of Machindye West, have spent 8 of them in prison.
Constituencies to be represented. 8 months, they are not trying, and I am happy the Attorney General is here. When it came to the election of the Speaker, in 1 hour, they are given legal interpretation that elections must be conducted.
On a positive note, this year ends with a bumper harvest in the legislative agenda of the August House, with 12 bills passed into the law and 6 assented by the President. High on the agenda is the NSSF Amendment Bill, which was passed to provide savers a window of midterm access of their savings. Others were the East African Crude Oil Pipeline Bill, Electricity Bill, Landlord and Tenants Bill, among others.
We've also made very good milestones on the oil sector by way of passing the bill that allows the ECO pipeline to be constructed, as well as a legal framework to guide on how money or revenues made out of oil should be spent.
Members of Parliament have a strong belief that they have been able to live to the people's expectations in the first year.
For me, and a member of Parliament from the fishing community, we are happy with the Fisheries and Aquatic Bill and some of the issues that there is that will benefit my people.
The 11th Parliament has kept the House in check with several intensive probes that have exposed rot in management of public funds. 4 ad hoc committees have been formed in this aspect and all delivered their reports, save for Naguru Nakawa Land Probe Select Committee that is winding up with its report.
I want to salute my colleagues, the honorable members of Parliament, for the achievements so far we've done. It hasn't been an easy time. You know, this has been a pandemic era where during the corona time, so many people thought that maybe even Parliament will take more than 5 years or 4 years without settling down. But now we are back in the House, and maybe we are trying to do our best. We are not angels.
However, their failure to address the skyrocketing prices of essential commodities and fuel is still haunting many members of the 11th House. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News in Parliament.